Today I flew from Austin to Portland. Here's how that went. From learning to traveling adventures, subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell icon to be notified when I post a video every Wednesday. Today I had one goal, get to Portland to visit my sister. She's lived there for a few years now, and I haven't really had a good excuse not to visit her besides money. There's also a global pandemic on still, so I don't know why I waited until now to make the trip, but here we are.
Please do your part by practicing safe social distancing, washing your hands regularly, and wearing a protective face covering during your time here at AUS. Thank you.
On more than one occasion before going to the airport, I fill up my water bottle thinking about hydration and not thinking about the liquid restrictions on flights.
Not this time, TSA.
Also, in this particular instance, I needed to be more mentally prepared for the heat caused by all the layers I was wearing.
I'm very, very hot right now. These layers are not a good idea in Austin, but they will be in Portland, so. I've got that going for me.
In past flights, I was a little bit more comfortable talking with the person next to me and getting to know them, but with the regulations put in place that required masks, this was a little bit more difficult. You either have to yell, get really close, or take off the mask. So I felt like I was yelling the whole time. The full flights were a mandatory get close to your neighbor, and I had to take off my mask anyway to eat. Also, I'm an introvert and relatively shy, so talking to my neighbor felt even more strained because I wasn't sure of their comfort levels. I ended up watching my emotionally cathartic show, reading my book, and looking out the window. I'm working while I'm away, but I'm also thinking about YouTube, which means two laptops and a camera with equipment. What does that mean? More weight. So while yes, everything fits into a carry-on bag and a personal item, it feels like it weighs a metric ton. Gravity, am I right? This also means that I was really just rushing to the next spot to put down my bags. I wasn't able to experience much of the airport. Comment below and tell me your favorite airport and why. I think mine's Singapore because it's so green inside the airport.
Today we're not only going to Portland, but we're practicing talking to a camera in public. It wasn't a big deal when I was taking selfies, or it became not a big deal, but now that it's actually talking, it's a different story. I imagine this will be something like my first video ever, which I've recently seen and want to take it down, but I'm not going to. So this is going to be like that. Apparently I can only talk to myself when there's no one around.
But if I keep trying, then I'll get used to it. Theoretically.
You can't find me because I'm in the departures instead of arrivals, and she went to arrivals, which anyone would have gone to, so that's fun. So she's going around again.
Hello! Are you here to pick me up? I want to document this part of my life with my sister because she's important to me, and we're closer now than we ever were growing up. I don't get to see her as often as I'd like, so this next few weeks is going to be us just doing different things in Portland. So thanks for watching, make sure to smash the like button. Don't forget to subscribe and share it with your friends, and I'll see y'all next week. Bye.
Where to first?
So first we are going to
It's all around.
How did this happen? Did you just wear like a really tight rubber band one day?
No, I kept dying.
Normal, this is how we usually drive.